Hi guys. Now before I start, I just want to point out Python is a fantastic language to learn. Now, if you're learning this as your first programming language, that's amazing because Python is probably, for my sake at least, one of the easiest programming languages to learn. Now let's get on to strings. So, strings in Python, as we've already seen, are characters denoted in quotation marks, right? So I could say a variable my name and set it in a value of quotation marks, some characters, right? Let's do my actual name for Python's sake. And we've talked about adding, so operators, addition, stuff like that. So my quiz or my question here right now is, I'm going to create a variable, first name, set that equal to Avi. I'm going to create a second variable, second name, set that equal to Jane. I should have actually created the last name, but that's fine. And now what I want you to do is create a variable called full name, which has the sum of full first name and second name. Now, if you're already a step ahead of me, concept's quite simple. First name plus second name. And if you now print out full name, you get Avi Jane. So you see this error of a space, right? And probably the easiest way we can get rid of that is by adding a quotation marks in the middle with a space. So first name plus quotation marks with a space plus second name. So now if we print out full name, we will now get Avi Jane. Awesome. Now the question I give to you is, suppose I give you this text, Avinash, and then gibberish, okay? And the goal, or sorry, I was actually supposed to assign that to a variable. So, random should be equal to, and then let me just copy this, command C. All right, random is equal to Avinash, gibberish, blah, blah, blah. And the goal I'm trying to give you here is, hey, I want you to return me Avinash. That's it. I don't want any of the gibberish stuff. I don't want the space I have over here. All I want is this clear and simple Avinash. How do I do that? Well, thanks to Python, we now have the slice operator. Now, the core concept of slice is you can get or you can slice any part of the string from wherever to wherever. The way it works, you type in random and then you type the two square brackets. And in the square brackets, let's go give it a try. So I'm going to go through several example cases so that you get the idea of what's happening, and then we'll actually slice out Avinash. Now, first example case. Let's say you just wanted the first letter or a single letter. Hey, what's the 10th letter in this statement? You're going to say random 10. What does it give out? B. If you actually wanted to count, Avinash is 7, 8, 9, 10. So you're probably wondering, hey, Avinash is 7 plus the space 9, 10. Why has it given me B instead of what I think is I? And the reason it's done this is because the indexing of almost everything in Python starts at zeros. When we get to arrays or actually lists and dictionaries, indexing starts at zero. So think about it like this. The first character in the string, its position is the zeroth position, then 1, then 2, then 3. For example, now, if I wanted to get the actual 10th position, I do 10 minus 1, right? If you wanted to get the xth position in the string, you do x minus 1. It's that simple. So if I wanted to get the actual 10th position, I do random 9, and I'd get I. Cool. So the next case is I want to get a slice. Let's say from the first character to the fourth character. How do I do that? Well, we've talked about this. So what's the first character in the list? Well, the index position is 0. So we do random, and then using the slice function, we do 0. Now we say colon, hey, we got the first position. Where do we want to go up to? Well, we're going to say, let's say I want to go to maybe the, let's say Avi. So I believe that's the third. So 0 to 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, but it won't count the 3. Exactly. So the slice function here, what it's saying is, give me the first position, right? So where do you want me to slice from? and then give me one after your end position. For example, I wanted Avi. A is 0, V is 1, I is 2. Instead, I gave 0 to 3 so that it returns me 0, 1, 2. The last one, 3, isn't counted. Now, with this knowledge, go ahead, do a quick challenge here. Give me Avinash, or whatever statement you've given me, or written, give me your name. So, I'm going to pause the video. You should hopefully do this. It's actually just one simple statement. Let's take a look. Alright, hopefully you managed that. If you didn't, that's absolutely fine. We're going to do random 0, okay? And I, like I've talked about, my name is how many characters? It's 7, right? So let's go ahead and put in 7. Now, if you realize, I've already thought one step ahead. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then one more, which is 7. So 0 to 7, and I get Avinash. Fantastic. Now, before I end this lecture, there's one more thing I want to cover. Let's say I wanted everything from the third character. So I wanted Nosh Gibberish. What would I do then? Well, it's actually quite simple. I'm going to use the slice function and say random from the third character, which is 2, to everything after that. Random 2 colon. And once I do that, I get Inosh, Gibberish, blah, blah, blah. So these are a few simple functions that you can use with the splice. So whenever you have a string and you're trying to get a specific string out of that string, you can use the splice function. Fantastic! So we learned a lot in this lecture. First thing first, we learned about strings, how to add strings, adding that extra gap. After that, we learned how to get a specific string out of the main string. So searching and splicing. That's the core concept. Nice. Now, in the next lecture, what I want to talk about is the next data type. So we've discussed about integers, we've talked about strings. Let's go ahead and move on to lists, okay? See you in the next lecture.